listen to them? Will you listen to them? They're tearing the place apart! Come on, we gotta start the show now!
Take it easy. When Al's ready, he'll come out.
I can't wait any longer. I'll get it myself.
Forget it, pal. Nobody disturbs Mr. Yankovic before the show.
But...
Look, Al needs just a little bit of quiet time before he comes out, and then we'll go upstairs and we'll start the show. So back off.
Oh, yeah, that's good. That's good, yeah. Oh. Hello.
One spot, you know where I mean? It's not quite loose yet.
So.
You think you can do a little acupuncture on me?
Hey! Oh, great.
No, I don't think that's gonna do it.
Yeah?
No, Haji, come on, don't play games with me. You know what I need.
Ah, hi, aru yakubiku-san. So.
That did it, Haji. That really hit the spot. I'm focused, I'm relaxed, I'm ready to rock and roll. Let's do it! Woo! Woo!
What's with that hair?
I love being out on the road, but, you know, it's kind of tough being away from home for so long. I really miss my folks. I think about them a lot. I guess I had a pretty interesting childhood. When I was about 6 years old, a door-to-door salesman came to our house offering music lessons. My parents had to choose between guitar lessons and accordion lessons, and, of course, they chose the accordion, thereby solidifying my position as the person most likely to get beat up by a football player. But now that accordion music is so completely dominating 20th century pop culture, and accordion players have become the sex symbols of our modern age. Well, I'm just thankful that my parents were such visionaries. They've always been incredibly supportive. They've both had a profound impact on my life. My mom, for example, gave birth to me, which as it turns out was a real turning point in my career. But, you know, I think it's my dad who was most responsible for my attitude towards life. He always told me, son, as long as you follow your dream, as long as you're doing what truly makes you happy, we'll always be proud of you.
I just don't know where we went wrong.
He was such a smart boy. What happened?
We were hoping he'd have a real job by now.
I'm so ashamed.
You know, back when Alfred was in school, he was real good in math.
His junior year in high school, we even let him do our taxes.
I don't like prison.
So many people have influenced my career. Spike Jones, Alan Sherman, Stan Freberg, Tom Lehrer, Tito Puente, Debbie Boone, the list goes on. But no one single person has influenced my music more than my very own grandfather, the legendary blues pioneer, Blind Lemon Yankovic.
Well, you know, I suppose my real claim to fame is writing the world's shortest blues song, and I'm gonna play it for you right now. I didn't wake up this morning. Thank you. Thank you very much. You know, when Alfie was a little boy, he always used to say to me, Grandpa, would you teach me how to play the blues? So I took a cat of nine tails to the boy's backside, because after all, the blues cannot be taught, but they can be felt. I call that the blacked blues, or as my granddaddy used to say, a chicken that barks like a dog cannot get to the other side of the road. Young Alfie used to always come around and visit with his kinfolk down on the bayou in Linwood, California. Then he got himself all famous. I taught that boy everything he knows, and now I'm lucky to get a postcard from him. All that big city living, money, fame, fast cars, big mansions, beautiful women, two-ply toilet paper. Now that's all well and good, but you just can't go around forgetting your roots like that.
Well, I heard that you're leaving.
Leaving.
Gonna leave me far behind.
So far behind.
'Cause you found a brand new lover. You decided that I'm not your kind. So I pulled your name out of my Rolodex. And I tore all your pictures in two. And I burned down the malt shop where we used to go. Just because it reminds me of you. That's right,
that's right.
You ain't gonna see me crying.
I'm glad
that you found somebody new. 'Cause I'd rather spend eternity eating shards of broken glass than spend one more minute with you. I guess I might seem kind of bitter. You got me feeling down in the dumps. 'Cause I'm stranded all alone in the gas station of love, and I have to use the self-service pumps. Oh, so honey, let me help you with that suitcase.
You ain't
gonna break my heart in two. 'Cause I'd rather get a 100,000 paper cuts on my face than spend one more minute with you. I'd rather rip out my intestines with a fork than watch you going out with other men. I'd rather slam my fingers in a door again and again and again and again and again. Oh, can't you see what I'm trying to say, darling? I'd rather have my blood sucked out by leeches.
Leeches.
Shove an ice pick under a toenail or two. I'd rather one more minute with you. I'd rather rip my heart right out of my rib cage with my bare hands and then throw it on the floor and stomp on it till I die. Then spare one more minute.
Back when I was first starting out, I used to write a lot of songs about food. I guess that's because I eat food just about every day, so, you know, it's always been very inspirational to me. First of all, there was the Joan Jett takeoff.
I love Rocky Road, so have another triple scope with me.
And the Robert Palmer takeoff.
Might as well face it, you're addicted to spuds.
And, of course, the Michael Jackson takeoff.
Just eat it. It doesn't matter what you had for lunch. Just eat it, eat it, eat it, eat it. Eat it, eat it, eat it, eat it.
Do you have any idea what it's like having to go through life being known as the Eat It Guy? No, of course you wouldn't, because I'm the Eat It Guy. Well, I've decided to put the whole food thing behind me. I've decided to really stretch myself as a songwriter and write songs about things I know absolutely nothing about. Ow! Whoa! Easy there, Clancy. Both hands on the wheel. Where was I? Oh, never mind. You know, as much as I miss being home, being on the bus with my band is kind of like being with family. Jim, Steve, and Bermuda, they've all been with me since the early 80s. We added a new keyboard player just a couple years ago, so, of course, being the new guy, he has to do a lot of the stuff that nobody else wants to.
Al.
Yeah, what is it?
Could I talk to you about something?
Sure, Ruben, go ahead.
Well, I'm embarrassed by this.
What, the cone bra? Come on, it's an important part of the show.
Yeah, but I'm gonna have friends in the audience tonight, and...
There's nothing to be embarrassed about. You look great. Believe me, if you looked ridiculous, I'd tell you.
Really?
Absolutely.
Yeah, but I'm just embarrassed. I mean, there's people
look... You look fabulous. This is a really good look for you.
Really?
Yeah. I want you to go out there tonight and show me everything you've got.
Okay, Al. Thanks.
See that I've been here we go. surgeon. Like a surgeon, here's a waiver for you to sign. Whoa, 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 it's a fact.
So many people have had a direct impact on my career. Sometimes I wish I could personally sit down with each and every one of them and tell them how much I appreciate everything they've done for me. But of course, that would be a huge hassle and take up way too much of my free time. However, one person does deserve special mention. The man who gave me my start and exposed my music to a nationwide audience on a syndicated radio show. The one and only Dr. Demento. Dr. D would play my stuff on the radio back when I was just a teenager. Back when I was recording songs in the bathroom because I couldn't afford a real recording studio. In fact, my first big hit on his show was a song called My Bologna, and it was actually recorded in the bathroom across the hall from my college campus radio station.
Ooh, my little hungry one, open up a package of My Bologna.
The next year, I performed the Queen parody, Another One Rides the Bus, live on the Dr. Demento show, and it became his most requested song ever.
Hey! He's gonna sit by you, another one rides the bus.
A couple years and a few incriminating Polaroids later, I was able to land my very own recording contract. You know, I don't think there's any way I can possibly repay the good doctor for everything he's done for me. But as a small token of my appreciation, just because I know it means a lot to him, every Sunday afternoon in the park, I give him a horsey ride.
Woo! Woo! Ride him, cowboy! Woo!
You know, nothing makes you long for the comfort of home and family more than traveling across the country in a bus with a big, smelly rock band. You know, sometimes life on the road can get a little tiresome, and one way that we like to break up the monotony is by stopping at various points of interest along the way to pick up a few souvenirs. For instance, just yesterday I was in a cute little place called Bugs and Stuff, just outside of Rockford, Illinois. That's where I picked up this little beauty. They call it a scorpion farm. See, the clear glass container allows you to easily study the daily routine of the vicious, poisonous red scorpion. let's just move on. You know, performing on the road all these many years, I've stayed in hundreds, possibly thousands of hotels. And you know, the really cool thing about staying in hotels is all the free stuff they put in the rooms. Well, needless to say, I've amassed quite a collection of hotel memorabilia. For example, here are just a few of the jewels in my hotel soap collection. You know, every bar of soap has a memory. This bar. This reminds me of a great show we did in St. Louis. And, this one. This reminds me of my first trip to Paris. Man, what a city. And, this one. This reminds me of the time I got a tattoo of John Tesh on my butt. Oh, boy, if this soap could only talk, huh?
Since you've been gone, well, I feel like I've been chewing on tin foil. Since you've been gone, it's like I got a great big mouthful of cod liver oil. Well, I'm feeling like I stuck my hand inside a blender and turned it on. You know I've been in a buttload of pain since you've been gone.
Well, since you've been gone. Since you've been gone,
I couldn't feel any worse if you dropped a two-ton bowling ball on my toes.
Since you've been gone,
it couldn't hurt anymore if you shoved a red-hot cactus up my nose. Since you've been gone, well, I feel like I'm getting tetanus shots every day. Since you've been gone, it's like I got an ice cream hand. That won't go away. Ever since the day you left me, I've been so miserable, my dear. I feel almost as bad as I did when you were still here.
Being on the road can be both physically and emotionally draining. Believe me, it's not always the glamorous kind of lifestyle you might expect. So when we're out on the road, traveling from town to town, giving away a piece of our souls every night on stage, I think the very least we can expect in return is some decent room service.
Uh-huh. Right, right. 27 Twinkie Wiener sandwiches, a case of ding-dongs, a giant lump of tofu in the shape of Pat Sajak's head, and a champion sumo wrestler who sings show tunes and shoots seedless grapes across the room from out of his belly button. You got all that? Great. All right, be here in 12 minutes or else no tip. I really don't know what to say here. You know, I thought this was a 4-star hotel. Are you trying to tell me that this is supposed to look like Pat Sajak? It looks more like Alex Trebek.
I'm sorry, Mr. Yankovic.
And where's the gooey, cream-filled center?
You never said anything about it.
Do I have to spell everything out for you people? I better not be disappointed with dessert.
Oklahoma, where the wind comes sweeping down the plain, where the waving wheat sure smells sweet when the wind comes right behind the rain. Oklahoma, every night, my honey.
I don't know why, but it just tastes better this way.
Out. How do the words
know, ever since I became a big-time famous celebrity, it's become difficult for me to just do a lot of the ordinary things I like to do. For example, going to the grocery store, you know? I can't even go to the grocery store without people hounding me, saying things like, "Hey, Al, how's it going?" Or, "Hey, Al, I'm sorry, this coupon is for the crunchy peanut butter." Or, "Hey, Al, come back here, you didn't pay for that." It's enough to drive you crazy. Still, I really enjoy meeting new and interesting people, and I'm always amazed by the effect I seem to have on their lives.
What makes me Weird Al's number one fan? How about the fact that I have Al tattooed on my tongue? That's because, like, you know, life is like a banquet on which we feed and stuff. So every time I take a bite out of life, I do it with Al. The only bad thing is that the tattoo killed all my taste buds. But who needs taste when you've got Weird Al?
Get out. I am Weird Al's number one fan by far. See this? This sweater is woven from 100% Weird Al belly button lint. That's right. And I will not rest until everything I wear is a natural byproduct of Weird Al.
These chumps are pretenders, man. I'm his number one fan. I've had a chip implanted in my head that plays Yoda over and over and over again, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. You hear that? Yo, 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 Yoda.
I'm his biggest fan.
Yoda.
Thanks for coming.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Take care.
Hi. Let me tell you, Weird Al, man, I'm your biggest fan. Without you, I would have never done nothing with my life, man. You're the gas in my tank, brother. The flame to my fire, the egg in my omelet. You know why? Because I got the messages, man. That's right. I played Eat It Backwards, man. And I know we're all gonna eat it when the snakes rise up, man. And it's because of you, man. Without you, my life would have no meaning, man.
Well, thanks, I guess.
I'm your biggest fan, Weird Al! Weird Al rules!
Sometimes I feel like I need a vacation. Sometimes I feel like I wanna go to the city of cavemen, the city of bedrock. I'd be a Flintstone, now I'll tell you why. Anybody seen her?
Yellow Dog, this is Blue Velvet. Yellow Dog, this is Blue Velvet. The Weird Al Yankovic record signing will commence at 1400 hours.
Roger, copy that, Blue Velvet. Now, Mr. Yankovic, before we appear at the drop zone, I should debrief you.
Okay.
Hey, ow!
We are at ground zero. The eagle is leaving the nest.
Mother Goose, this is Chicken Little. The fox has left the hen house.
Chicken Little, this is Weasel Boy. The swallows have arrived at Capistrano.
I am in the drop zone. The sparrow has laid an egg.
All right, Mr. Yankovic, it's party time. Stick with me and those lunatics out there won't lay a finger on you. The albatross is massaging a porpoise with cheese. I repeat, the albatross is massaging a porpoise with cheese. This is not a drill. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Keep your head down. Run, run, run.
Called to ask me to be in his video for Amish Paradise. Well, you can imagine my surprise. I don't know how he got my home phone number. He still won't tell me. But I decided to appear in the video anyway, because to be honest, it was a chance for me to really dig deep as an actor and get into the role of an Amish ingenue. So to prepare for the role, I had all the electricity shut off in my house, and I ate nothing but potatoes and shoe fly pie for over a month. That's because I pay attention to every little detail, just like Al does. In fact, I'd have to say that the only thing that really separates the two of us is my restraining order.
Ah, yes, there hath been much talk of the one who calleth himself Weird Al. Though some would say what he hath done is a foul mockery of our ways, the scripture doth teach us to forgive our transgressors, and so I shall. But in truth, it would bring me much joy to trample him with my buggy.
As I walk through the valley where I harvest my grain, I take a look at my wife and realize she's very plain. But that's just perfect for an Amish like me. You know I shun fancy things like electricity. At 4:30 in the morning, I'm milking cows. Jebediah feeds the chickens and Jacob plows. Fool, and I've been milking and plowing so long that even Ezekiel thinks that my mind is gone. I'm a man of the land, I'm into discipline. Got a Bible in my hand and a beard on my chin. But if I finish all of my chores and you finish thine, then tonight we're gonna party like it's 1699. We've been spending most our lives living in an Amish paradise. I've turned body once or twice. But last week, I just smiled at him and I turned the other cheek. I really don't care, in fact, I wish him well, 'cause I'll be laughing my head off when he's burning in hell. But I ain't never punched a tourist, even if he deserved it. An Amish with a tool, you know that's unheard of. I never wear buttons, but I got a cool hat. And my homies agree, I really look good in black, fool. If you come to visit, you'll be bored to tears. We haven't even paid the phone bill in 300 years. But we ain't really cranes, so please don't point and stare. We're just technologically impaired. There's no phone, no lights, no motor car. Not a single luxury like Robinson Crusoe. It's as primitive as can be. We've been spending most our lives living in an Amish paradise. We're just plain and simple guys living in an Amish paradise. There's no time to sit and vice. lots of butter. Raise the barn on Monday, soon I'll raise another. Think you're really righteous? Think you're pure in heart? Well, I know I'm a million times as humble as thou art. I'm the pious guy, the little omelets wanna be like, on my knees day and night, scoring points for the afterlife. So don't be vain and don't be whiny, or else my brother, I might have to get medieval on your hiney. We've been spending most our lives living in an Irish paradise. We're all crazy men and nights living in an Irish paradise. There's no cops or traffic lights living in an Irish paradise. But you'd probably think it bites living in an Irish paradise.
Hot out there tonight.
Oh, come on, let's go. This is a quick one.
I'm ready.
Mongo, let's do it.
Incoming.
Get off me, man. Stop it.
You ain't down with us no more. You ain't fat. You ain't fat.
You ain't fat. You ain't nothing. You ain't nothing.
All right, Al, 25 seconds left. Better move on to the jelly field.
Let's go! Get these boots on! Push!
15 seconds, come on, Al. Don't bother chewing. Let's go!
Almost there, you can do it!
Donuts!
Those are for Al!
Come on, Al, almost there!
5 seconds, go, go, go!
There's your cue!
Go get him, champ!
Your body's wide, your mind is too. Just watch your mouth, or I'll sit on you. The word is out, better treat me right. Cause I'm the king of cellulite. Have on, have on, have on whole wheat. Alright. My zip is bust, my buckles break. I'm too much man for you to take. The pavement cracks when I fall down. I've got more chins than Chinatown. Well, I never use a phone booth, and I never see my toes. When I'm going to the movies, I take up 7 rows because I'm fat. I'm fat, jam on. You know. Get my mail. It measures on the Richter scale. Down at the beach, I'm a lucky man. I'm the only one who gets a tan. If I have one more, I add a mode. I'm gonna need my own zip code.
When you only have the seconds, I'm having 23rds. When I go to get my shoe shine,
get
Well, this is it. We're finally here. Wow, it's been such a long time since I've been home. I'm really looking forward to seeing my mom and dad, and I'm pretty sure they're excited about this, too. In fact, I wouldn't be too surprised if they're planning a big coming home party in my honor. They always tend to go a little overboard at times like this.
Hello, can I help you?
Mom, it's me, Al.
Oh, hi. And who are all these people with you?
That's the camera crew, Mom. We're filming a big special all about me for the Disney Channel.
Disney Channel, huh? Well, then I better tell your father to put some pants on.
Who are you?
Dad, it's me! Your son! Alfred.
Uh-huh. Does your mother know you're here?
Yes, of course she knows I'm here. Dad, I've been all around the world on tour, and I finally come home.
Why, do you need some money?
No. Grandpa Blind Lemon, hey, how are you? It's been ages.
Alpha Boy, is that you? Come on over and sit next to your granddaddy, because I got a question I'm just dying to ask you.
Sure, Grandpa, what is it?
Does this look infected to you?
Mom, Dad, Grandpa Blind, I can't tell you what this means to me, to be back in my childhood home, surrounded by family, eating my favorite home-cooked meal, tamale pie. It's been a long day. You know, I think after dinner, I'm just gonna take my stuff up to my room and crawl right into bed.
I don't think that'd be a good idea, Alfred.
Why not?
Well, you see, you've been gone so long, we didn't know if you were ever gonna come back, so...
What they're trying to tell you, boy, is that they rented out your room.
What? My room? To who?
He's a very nice person.
He's in show business like you.
He might be in show business, but he ain't like you, boy. Hi, everybody. I'm home. Hi. Woo! Tamale pie, my favorite. Oh, hi. Who's your friend?
Ed, this is our son, Alfred. Alfred is Ed McMahon.
Yeah, I know who he is. Look, before I take another bite, are there any other surprises you want to tell me about?
I'm not sure this is the time.
But, Mom, you told me honesty was the most important thing in our family.
You're right, son. Alfred, there's something I ought to tell you about your grandpa, Blind Lemon Yankovic.
But don't tell me he's not really blind.
No, he's blind, all right.
What they're trying to tell you is that he's not really your grandfather.
What?
You're sure as stupid, even for a white boy.
That's it. I've had enough. You're all crazy. I'm leaving.
You're right. He's really emotional.
If you need me, I'll be at the Holiday Inn.
Alfred, wait, son. Don't leave.
You can sleep on the sofa next to Grandpa.
That's all right with me, son. Yeah, come back.
Wait a minute. Wait, you know, this is ridiculous. I don't have to leave. Okay, so maybe he's not my grandfather. You know, for that matter, who knows? Maybe you're not my real parents. But does that really matter? No, I don't think it does. What does matter is you both raised me into the person that I am today. It was you who taught me to know right from wrong, to know good from bad. To recognize when mayonnaise-based foods have spoiled. Mom, it was you who gently rocked me to sleep when I had nightmares. And Dad, it was you who tied me to a radiator grill in the far corner of the basement when my cries kept you up at night. This is what makes people a family. Not silly things like love and genetics and DNA. No, the point is, we have lived side by side through good times and bad, through thick and thin, as a family. Sure, I may have been left on your doorstep by a band of desperate traveling polka gypsies, but you are the people I will always call Mom and Dad!
That's nice, boy! Yeah, that was good.
That was quite a speech, son.
Thanks, Dad.
But you're still not getting your room back.
I met him in a swamp in Dagobah, where it bubbles all the time like a giant carbonated soda. S-O-D-A, soda. I saw the little runt sitting there on a log. I asked him his name, and in a raspy voice he said, Yoda. Y-O-D-A, Yoda. Yo-yo-yo-yo-yoda. If you start to go astray, let the force be your guide. Oh, my Yoda. Yo, 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 Yoda. I know those leaders really got you annoyed, but remember if you kill them, then you'll be unemployed. Oh, my Yoda. Yo, 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 Yoda. Wow! Apparently my friends really got in a mess, so I'm gonna have to leave Yoda, I guess. But I know that I'll be coming back someday. I'm a man. Na get it, 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 na get it